This is Twit.
They don't mention the big beard and the Santa Claus laugh, but he's definitely hip. Ladies and gentlemen, our home theater geek, Scott Wilkinson's here, contributor to Tech Hive and Projector Central. And hey, Scott.
Hey, Leo. How's it going?
It's going well. How are you?
Doing good. Thanks.
You have a big article about projector technology in
yes.
the current issue of Projector Central.
The current issue.
Online. I don't know what you call it now. It's just,
Today's front page, I guess you'd
say. How about that?
I mean, you know, I'm a print jockey from way back, and so I certainly am very familiar with, you know, the current issue. But yeah, you're right. It's at the top of the page on projectorcentral.com, and it's a giant article.
What is it about? And it looks like it's about technologies.
It is. It's a technology, what we sometimes call a tech-splainer.
Yeah.
Which is explanations of technology. And Projector Central asked me to explain the different projector technologies, that is the technologies behind today's digital projectors. And there are three different technologies that are used in digital projectors, not only for home theater, but also for digital cinema, for education, for classrooms, even though their classrooms are much less populated these days. Museums, theme parks,
you go to a rock concert these days.
You see projectors.
They don't bother with the big sets anymore. They don't need to. They could project absolutely lifelike backdrops and change them at the drop of a hat.
That's right. That's right. And so all these applications use projectors. And there are only three technologies that are used in all of these applications. One is called LCD, liquid crystal display, liquid crystal diode, I guess is the original thing. LCOS, liquid crystal on silicon, and DLP, digital light processing, which is from Texas Instruments. Now, they all work roughly the same way. You have little imagers that are maybe an inch across. Tiny little screens, super tiny. Well, they're an inch across, but on these inch across screens are microscopic pixels.
Right.
And they form these images.
So it's like,
and then that gets projected onto the screen to a much larger picture.
It's like you've got a little TV in the projector, which it then uses lenses and projects onto the screen. So really it makes sense that the three technologies you talk about are actually three common technologies in television as well,
yes,
right?
Exactly. Well, LCOS isn't. You don't see an LCOS TV or DLP for that matter. DLP and LCOS
used to be big.
Really,
used to be,
well,
DLP.
Again, but it was a projection technology.
Right.
It was a small chip that formed the image, and then a lens blew that up.
Right.
In that case, on a rear projection TV screen.
There's one other difference. If you were to watch these little teeny weeny inch big screens in the projector, they wouldn't look like a normal picture, would they?
No, they're monochrome. They only would have one color.
Red, green, and blue?
Well, in the projector, you have to have three of them. One for red, one for green, and one for blue. If you watched only one of them at a time, it would only be one color.
Interesting. Okay.
So you have to have three of them in a projector. And
why do they do that? Why don't they just have a full color single screen and project that?
Well, because all video images, color video images, have to be a combination of red, green, and blue.
Right.
And maybe some other colors as well, but at least red, green, and blue. And so if you were to have a one-inch screen that was full color, each of those microscopic pixels would actually have to have three subpixels, one red, one green, and one blue. That's how an LCD TV works. That's how an OLED TV works. If you get right up against an LCD or an OLED TV, I mean, like you put your nose on the glass and you look, you'll probably see, maybe even with a magnifying glass these days with 4K and 8K TVs, you might need a magnifying glass to see tiny little red, tiny little green, tiny little blue, what we call subpixels.
So by doing that inside the projector with one-inch screens, they can get a higher resolution because...
Correct.
Get it. One's red, one's green, one's blue. And it's like having... Is it like three times the resolution of each individual screen?
No. No, it's not, because they overlap each other perfectly. Or at least they have to. They have to be aligned perfectly. And that's one of the problems with these three-chip projectors. Most projectors are three-chip. There's one exception. But those three images, the red image, the green image, and the blue image, have to be perfectly aligned, or else you see color fringing in the picture.
And I've seen that in some older projectors. That was a big problem. Yeah.
It's a big problem. Exactly right. Now, these days, it's gotten better. And the best projectors, you don't really see it. There is one exception I mentioned, and that's one chip or single chip DLP. Now, here's a case where a DLP projector can have only one of these little one-inch imager chips. And how does it get red, green, and blue on the screen then? It does it sequentially. It puts the green image, the red image on the screen, then the green image, then the blue image in rapid succession. So rapid that they blend together in your brain and you see a full color image.
Is that color wheel that we talk about with?
Precisely. Okay. That's right. That's how they do it. They take a white light of some sort and they pass it through a spinning wheel, and the wheel has like pie wedges on
this
it.
This is such a Rube Goldberg device in here.
I know.
But it works.
It's hilarious, but it works. And it's amazing. And that's, in fact, the basis of most low-cost DLP projectors. The ones you see in the digital cinema, like Dolby Cinema, they have three DLP chips in them. They're true three-chip displays, one for red, one for green, and one for blue. But those are very expensive. We're talking six figures.
Yeah.
And so
is that why they're so expensive? Because
Yeah, because they need these three chips. And they also need a lot of light. I mean, they're super bright because they have to fill up a 20, 30, 40-foot long screen.
So what's the deal with L cost? Because that is something we don't see in television sets, only in projectors.
Used to see a few. There were a few L cost rear projection televisions back in the day when we had rear projection televisions.
But that's still projection. You don't do a direct view, I guess.
No, you can't. You can't. LCOS is what's called liquid crystal on silicon. So it's a little chip, just like an LCD chip, and the LCDs become more or less transparent and let light through them, either more light or less light, depending on the electrical current going to each pixel. But instead of the light passing directly through the chip and then onto the screen, it actually passes through the LCD, hits a mirror, and passes back through the LCD, and comes. It's like a reflective display.
Even more Rube Goldberg.
It's Rube Goldberg. However, I have to tell you that technology has the best blacks and the best contrast of any of all three of these technologies.
So if you're looking for a projector, should you say, I want LCOS?
It depends on your budget. They're typically more expensive than LCDs and one-chip DLPs. It depends on your budget. It depends on your circumstances. Do you want super bright in a room with some ambient light, or do you have a real home theater that you can darken?
Right. Now, doesn't my TV have lasers?
Yes.
I have a high-sense short-throw projector TV. It's quite expensive.
Correct. And it uses DLP technology.
Okay.
And the lasers have to do with the light source, the illumination source. And I didn't really address that issue in this article.
That is a big issue, though.
Because these
bulbs, when you replace them, are very expensive.
Very expensive. They cost hundreds of dollars typically, and they only last a year or two.
Yeah.
Whereas a laser will last you 20,000 hours.
That's why I got it. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And they keep their brightness throughout their whole lifespan.
Right.
Whereas lamps diminish in brightness over time.
So this is a great article, by the way. I highly recommend it. ProjectorCentral.com. The technologies, LCD, LCOS, and DLP that you find in common projectors, how it works. It's a tech-splainer from our mansplainer, Scott Wilkinson.